Hi everybody, this is Dipti Harshalvartak and welcome to my baking channel. Today I am going to show you yet another beautiful cake decoration technique. So for that I am going to make use of rice papers. So this technique is called as rice paper sail. So we are going to make beautiful decorations using the rice papers. Okay, so let me show you what all things we need for making our rice paper sails. Of course we need rice papers. So these rice papers, you get it locally available or you can definitely order them from Amazon as well. For making the rice paper sails, I'll be using my silicone mat. To give beautiful directions to my silicone mat, I'll be using some cloth clips as well. For coloring my rice paper decorations, I'll be using some gel colors. Now these gel colors, or you can use liquid colors as well. Whatever products I'm using today, I'm giving you the link of these products in the description box below, so you can check out the products that I'm using for making these decorations. For soaking our rice papers, I'll be using some lukewarm water, right? And after our rice paper sails are ready, you can use this gold dust decoration. So you can paint your rice paper sails using gold dust as well, right? So let's get started. Let me show you how to make these rice paper sails. After they are done, I'm going to also show you how to arrange them beautifully on a cake, right? So let's get started. For making rice paper sails, I'm using this rice paper over here, and here I have taken some lukewarm water. All right, I'm using some gel color, just a drop of it. In this colored water, then I'm going to soak my rice paper sheet. Can you see how it's curling up? So the moment it comes in contact with water, it starts curling up. Let it sit in the water for about 1 minute. And in the meantime, what you can do is keep this aside. Take a silicone mat. Okay, so this is a silicone mat, and what I have done is I have made two folds on it, one over here and the other over here. Okay, so this is how I'm going to place my rice paper over here. So you make this arrangement and keep the silicone mat ready. It's been 1 minute and now you can see how the rice paper is looking. It is looking like a cloth. Okay, so the idea is to place this on top of your mat and let it rest for a while. So when your rice paper is little bit sticky, you have to arrange it in such a way that it gets these type of curls on it. And we will let it rest for about 24 hours, for a day. Another rice paper, what I have done is I have cut it into two equal parts and then I am going to soak it in the water. Again, let it rest in the water for about a minute or so. Once it becomes soggy, you can place it on the silicone sheet. The other rice paper is also done. In a minute you will get a cloth like structure like this. Alright, so again, for this I am not going to change the shape of my silicone mat. I am just going to place it like this. When it becomes difficult to work with it, just make your fingers little bit wet and you can start working on it. Right, so I am just trying to give this natural curls. Let's do the other one as well. Take it, place it on the mat, and then just collect it together. We will set this for about 24 hours and then we will try to take it off from the silicone mats. It's been 24 hours and you can see how beautifully the rice paper has dried up. They are all dried up and they are coming off easily from the silicone mat. Okay, let me just open this one as well. So very carefully remove the pin and gently pick it up. See how beautiful this looks, right? This will add an amazing texture to your cake. This will add that rustic kind of an effect to your cakes. Okay, so you can put it like this on your cake, or you can put it like that as well. Now, in order to give it more depth, what we can do is we will start decorating it on the sides using gold dust. Use some petal dust or gold dust. Mix that gold dust with some lemon extract or baker spirit or alcohol like vodka. Okay. And what you can do is you can just start painting it on the sides. Just use it on the edges and it will look beautiful. This kind of decoration looks very good on your tall tier cake or on your wedding cakes as well. Both the tiers you can use these type of sail and it gives amazing rustic look to your cakes. It looks very, very artistic as well. Right, so I'm going to keep it aside so that it dries up very well. Now we will let this dry and then we will use it on the cake. So this thing will dry up very quickly. And once it dries up, it will look absolutely beautiful on the cake.
Now that our rice paper decorations are ready, we are going to arrange them beautifully on our cake. So let me show you how to do that.
So now I'm going to decorate this cake further by using this beautiful rice shell on top of it. So you can place it wherever you want, okay? You can place it on top. Generally on top it looks amazing, or you can put it on the sides as well, right? So I'm just going to place this particular portion. I'm just going to slide it inside my cake and let it stand like that, right? See, it looks beautiful. You can let it tilt a bit, right? This is what you can do. Remaining ones you can either put it below this or you can even put it on the sides, right? So you can put it like that or you can put it like this as well. You can further decorate this cake by putting macarons or by putting chocolates, again using a lot of gold dust on it. I have this meringue cookies which I had made.
So I hope you have loved this particular cake decoration technique. Do try this on your cakes and let me know how it goes. Few tips to remember when it comes to working with rice paper. Always use good quality rice papers. You can definitely order them from Amazon or you can source them locally. Soak them in a lukewarm water. The rice paper has to be soaked in lukewarm water only for a minute or so, right? After that, remove excess water and arrange it the way you want on a silicone mat so that they dry it in that particular direction only. You can either color the water or you can color the rice papers after they are done. You can paint them immediately while they are wet, or you can paint them after they are dried, right? Be gentle while you are trying to peel them off from the silicone mat, otherwise there are chances that the dried rice paper might break as well. And when you are arranging them on the cake, again you have to be very careful. Rice paper, when it comes in contact with moisture, it is going to be soggy. So when you are arranging your rice papers on a cake, you have to ensure that the cake stays in the AC room or in the refrigerator. Otherwise, the surface of the rice paper which is sticking to the cake, it is definitely going to be soggy, okay? Especially the rice paper on the top, if you see at the bottom, it is going to be soggy, and during the delivery it might just fall off. So what you need to do is, when you are going to deliver such a cake, always remember, after you take the picture and if you have sent it to the client, you take it out and put the rice papers in some separate box, okay? So give these decorations to your clients in a separate box and ask them to arrange it during the cake cutting ceremony. So I hope you have loved this particular technique. Do give it a try. If you have loved this particular video, give a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon so that whenever a new video comes in, you get notified about it. Thank you so much.